Are you smuggling a McDonald's Filet-O-Fish in your pants, or have you not taken a bath in a while? It's okay, because vaginas can have a unique smell to them, and sometimes it doesn't mean you're dirty. What's the good and bad vagina smells, and what's the worst, and a sign of something that happens to women at an alarming rate? The vagina is a pretty incredible organ. It has to be tough enough to handle the rigors of both sex and childbirth, and it's a pretty significantly large opening to the outside world through which germs can enter. This is why it has multiple systems to prevent infection and keep itself in good working order at all times. Smell can be produced by bacteria, the effect of different clothing materials on our skin, and gland secretions and hormone changes, even the food we eat. It's well known that people who like to eat a lot of spicy food will have a much stronger body odor and require more application of deodorant throughout the day than people who don't eat spicy dishes. All these factors also come into play with the vagina, only we highly recommend you don't try deodorizing it or you'll be in for a world of pain. Kind of like the time we put the bleach wipes next to our toilet wipes and used the bathroom at 3 a.m. If you think that's a fun plot hook for the sake of engagement, you'd be wrong. That's a 100% true story. So what's causing your coot chute to smell, and what smells are actually a sign that something very bad is going on? You're not going to get rid of vaginal smell. It's impossible. Even thorough bathing won't get rid of the unique aroma that your baby cannon puts out. Your vagina is constantly releasing some form of secretions, with up to 4 milliliters a day being perfectly healthy. This keeps your vagina lubricated, or else it would dry out thanks to its front door being perpetually held open. You really don't want to be dealing with a dry penis flytrap. The discomfort would be extreme. But these secretions also help fight off infection by flushing bacteria. So what's some good vaginal odor? A tangy or sour smell is actually good, because it means that your bacteria flora are healthy and working as intended. Vaginal bacteria produce lactic acid, hydrogen peroxide, and other antibacterial substances, as well as keeping your ham wallet's pH acidic in order to rein in runaway bacteria. Once your pH starts to drop, bacteria like yeast can set up shop, and unless you're in the baking business, that is bad news. By the way, despite the latest TikTok trend, please don't ever make your significant other baked goods from your natural yeast. That can actually make them very sick. A metallic smell can often accompany menstruation, and it's merely the smell of iron in the blood. Meanwhile, a bittersweet smell can be a sign of normally fluctuating bacteria populations. A bleachy kind of smell could be due to the presence of urine around the vulva, but if accompanied by itching or burning, that's a sign of infection. Alright, so what about bad vagina smells? And what's one of the worst smells that's a sign of something that's happening with disturbing regularity to women? Vaginas are commonly associated with a fishy smell, but if you're starting to smell like you belong on Deadliest Catch, then you need to see a gynecologist ASAP. A strong fishy smell can be a sign of bacterial vaginosis or trichomoniasis. Bacterial vaginosis happens when bad bacteria overpowers good bacteria, which means that you're almost certainly on the way to infection. Trichomoniasis, however, is a sexually transmitted infection accompanied by itching, burning, and a yellowish or greenish vaginal discharge. Luckily, your pink snapping turtle can be cured with simple antibiotics. A smell of rotting meat is a pretty strong warning sign of something having gone horribly wrong, and it happens disturbingly frequently. This is typically the result of a forgotten tampon literally plugging up your ladyworks, and it can result in a putrid smell accompanied by vaginal discharge that is every shade of awful. Inevitably, you'll end up with fever, pain around the pelvis and abdomen, and swelling of your hatchet wound. And if you don't have the tampon removed ASAP, it could lead to serious infection, including your body going septic. It sounds gross, but the truth is it happens more commonly than one might think. Now go check out 50 insane facts about the female body, or click this other video instead.